Good afternoon, students. So, students, in the previous classes, we have discussed about Chapter 2, Class 6, History, group, and we discussed about the three topics of that chapter. And chapter name is From Gathering to Growing Food. So, students, in that chapter, we have discussed how human beings change their habits. As earlier, how they were staying, how they were collecting the food, and all these things related to them. Then in the last class, we have discussed about fast farmers and herders towards settled life, peat house, and the different tools of the stone ages, and about finding of pottery. So students, those who have missed the last class topics, you all are advised to see the last video. So that will help you to understand more about this chapter From Gathering to Growing Food, which is a very important chapter for you. After the first chapter, if you will not see those videos, then it will be difficult for you to understand. Okay, so student, our today's topic is Living and Dying in Mehrgarh. A closer look, Living and Dying in Mehrgarh. So student, in this chapter we will discuss about how the people were living in the Mehrgarh, and how they what are the crops they were grown, and what happened in Mehrgarh after they were dying. So all these things we will discuss. So student, first we will discuss about Mehrgarh site, that is located in a fertile plain near the Bolan Pass. So that is an important route for the Iran. So it was probably the place where women and men learned to grow wheat and barley and rear sheep and goat for the first time in this area. And it is one of the most earliest villages that we know about. So student, this is the feature of Mehrgarh. If you will remember when we were discussing about the first chapter, I told you that before 8000 years ago, the areas between the Suleiman and Kirtha region, wheat and barley was grown there. And people spared the life of herders. They kept the animals, sheep and goat. So this Mehrgarh is in that area. This is between the Suleiman and Kirtha region. And there wheat and barley was grown. Along with that, people kept the animals, sheep and goat, and started sparing the life of herders. And this is the earliest villages. Okay, so then now we'll discuss about the traces of. Now we'll discuss about the next topic, the evidence of many kinds of animals bones from the earliest level has been found from the archaeologists during excavation, which include bones of wild animal such as the deer and pig, and in the later level they found more bones of sheep and goat, which and in still later levels cattle bones are most common, suggesting that this was the animal that was generally kept kept by the people. So from these bones which were recovered, different animals bone, so from there we are understanding here people are sparing the life of herders. They were keeping the animals, correct? So next we'll discuss about how their house was, which type of pattern their house was constructed. Okay, so remains of square and rectangular houses have been discovered from the Mehrgarh, and each house was four compartment, and some of the compartment may have been used for the storage. So their houses was constructed like rectangular or square type, and four compartment were there, along with the uses of the living room. Some of the apartments they were using for the storing of the grains for storage purpose. Next, we'll discuss about when people died, their relatives and friends pay respect to them and look after them, perhaps in the belief that there is some form of life after death. So when a person was getting death, so their relatives were paying respect to them and they were taking care of them, and they were believing that some form of life still exists after the death. That is why they were taking care of the after death of a human being. Okay, this was the belief of that time. Correct. So at Mehrgarh, several burial sites have been found. The dead person was buried with goats, which were probably meant to serve as food in the next world. So in different burial sites, along with the human being skeleton, the animal goats were recovered. So from this, it was observed that people who were dying in that time during their burial, along with that body, goat were also kept with that body. So they were believing that they will use as the food. That person used that goat as the food. So this was their belief. So the dead person buried with goats, which were probably meant to serve as food. So they were thinking that person may use that goat for their food, for his food. Correct. So student, this is all about the last topic of a closer look living dying in Mehrgarh. There we discussed how people were grown wheat and barley, how they spared the life of farmer, how they became the hoarder, and we discussed about the bone which were recovered from the different levels of the soil, upper level, middle level, and the lower level. Different types of animals' bones were recovered, like a dog, and along with the dog, some other animals were sheep, goat, and cattle, and about deer and pig. So all these animals' bones were recovered. So that is helpful for the archaeologists to understand that people were sparing the life of herders as well, along with the farmers. Then we discussed about the pattern of the houses. Then we discussed about squares and rectangular type of houses, along with the four compartments are there, and one house were used for the storage purpose. It is the belief of the archaeologist. Then we discussed that burial sites, so they were feeling that after the death of a person, relatives were paying respect to the body and they were taking care of the body, and they were thinking that some form of life is still existed after the death. So next, what happened when the bodies were buried? So along with the body, they were keeping goat with them. So they were thinking that goat will be used as the food for that person. Okay. So student, this is all about for today's topic. Any doubt you have, you can ask. And in the next class, we will discuss about a new topic. Correct. So exercise you will do, and any doubt you have, you can ask me. And in the next class, we'll start the new chapter. Okay, thank you for attending today's class.